Some closing thoughts here on Reliable Sources, and Jackie Kucinich talking about Mitt Romney's losing campaign in the final weeks. Not only was he not going on The View or Daily Show as Barack Obama did, he barely gave any interviews at all. You were along for much of that ride. What was it like being in that bubble?
Well, yeah, I mean, there wasn't a lot of access to the candidate. Now, the advisors were around a lot more in the last week, so you could talk to them. But the candidate himself... talk to them on the record. Yeah,
yeah.
You could do that. But as far as the candidate himself, no. I mean, the last day of the campaign, he came back to the back of the plane with a couple of reporters. But aside from that, there wasn't a lot. But at the same time, the president wasn't that open to reporters either.
The president having his first post-election news conference this Wednesday. But we talked earlier about David Petraeus and how maybe he's getting more sympathetic treatment for his fall from grace because he cultivated journalists. How much did Romney's inaccessibility as a candidate affect the coverage in your view, if at all?
I think it's hard because John McCain, of course, had a very good relationship with the press, and it's not like anyone pulled any punches at the end of that campaign either. So I think once you get to a certain level, that sort of erodes. But early on, I think it would have been a lot easier for him.
But we felt like we understood John McCain as somebody rode around on his bus back in the 2000 campaign. I'm not sure the journalists felt they really got Mitt Romney. Brief thought on that, Fred Francis?
Yeah, the fact is that John McCain, reporters ran out of questions to ask him. I mean, he would talk for...
Eight-hour rolling press conference.
8 hours.
Yeah.
You know,
I don't think anybody will do that in the age of Twitter.
Well, but maybe they should, okay? If they're secure in their own skin, if a politician is secure in his own skin and he can sit down and talk to reporters about what he really believes, okay, over and over, day after day, I think it helps him out in the end.
Do a lot of Republicans now want to be interviewed about the depth of this defeat, not just for Mitt Romney, but given the demographic problems that the GOP now faces, particularly with Hispanic voters? Are they going to be more open with the journalists now, do you think?
I think so. I mean, I think you saw a story in the Washington Post right after, it was either the day after or the next day, about some of the soul searching that they're doing. And I think we're going to be talking about this for a while.
Right. But what bothers me is the people who take the pot shots without being quoted.
This was the RNC coming out and saying, yeah, we're doing an after action report on this.
Before we go, bombshell news at the BBC with the Director General George Entwistle resigned yesterday. And of course, there has been the continuing embarrassment over the late talk show host Jimmy Savile and sex abuse charges involving hundreds of children, and now a program that inaccurately accused somebody of being involved in a pedophile scandal. It's a mess.
Yeah, it's probably the worst thing that's happened to the BBC in a very, very long time. Not just that the director general resigned, but many others should resign. And not just because of this latest mistake that they made, pointing the finger at someone in the House of Lords, but while some years ago, one of the BBC's own broadcasters was a pedophile, and they kept that secret for a long time and decided to hook the story and not do the story. And the reason this is important for the United States right now and why it's an interesting story is the director general of the BBC, former director general, Mark Thompson, will now, next week, take over as the head of the New York Times.
Of the New York Times Company, yes.
New York Times Company. I mean, the fact is that journalists have to be held responsible for these kinds of crazy stories. You'll remember 1993, Dateline NBC.
Yeah.
Crashed and burned.
Every news organization makes mistakes. It's how you handle it that determines how you're perceived by the public. And just briefly, Jackie Kucinich, hasn't been a great year for British journalism, going back to the Rupert Murdoch News of the World scandal.
And I think that's the real problem here. I mean, in all aspects of there's just a lot of work to do, I think, to rebuild public trust.
Yeah. It's not just the public trust. In Britain, but it's a public trust here, too, because it's a connected world. That BBC story was on every internet page.
Every time a news organization does something dumb, covers up, isn't straight with readers and viewers, it hurts the reputation of all journalists.
Very
Fred
true.
Francis, Jackie Kucinich, thanks for